From the station that made country music famous, 650 AM WSM, this is a Coffee, Country, and Cody podcast.
Hey, it's Charlie Maddox, and in this episode, we sit down with Grand Ole Opry star Travis Tritt. Travis had just played the Grand Ole Opry and just released a brand new single and a new album on the way soon. A lot to talk about with our friend Travis Tritt on our Coffee, Country, and Cody podcast. Here's a little of that new single, Smoke in a Bar.
It's a little bit too far from when the world turns slower and you could smoke in a bar. From when the world turns slower and you could smoke in a bar.
Please welcome the Surgeon General of Coffee, Country, and Cody this morning, Travis Tritt. Smoke in a bar could be dangerous to a singer's career. Hey, buddy, it is great to see you. Dropping new music today. And you did that at the Opry over the weekend past. And the full album, just so people know, is set in stone. It comes out May 7th. And I said earlier in the week, I said, it's been 13 years, I read, since new music, full album of new music from Travis Tritt. The only guy lazier than you is Leroy Parnell, who took 14 years to give us new music. I'm just saying. I'm just pointing that out, okay?
Yeah. Well, you know, lazy is one of my better traits.
At what point did Teresa say, you going to get off the couch and go in that studio, which, by the way, this is his home studio. I told him it looked like every control room I'd ever worked in, Megan, until I came to WSM. Yeah. And we had the Magnolia Lobby studio where Charlie is there this morning.
There you go. There you go, man. Yeah, this is where I always try to come when I've got a new song idea and I want to lay something down just to keep it fresh in my memory. This is where I come, to my home studio. So it's cool. You guys are kind of taking my Zoom virginity away. I just started on the Zoom stuff just yesterday. So,
oh, there you go.
Eric in Master Control, pull that audio clip.
That's right. Okay. It'll go viral.
Oprah thinks she's got the big tease going on. We got it now, Megan.
Yes. Oh, my goodness.
And Megan's guilty pleasure all morning long off the air when we're in a break is singing T-R-O-U-B-L-E.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, really?
Oh, I can't tell you how many nights I would go out with my girlfriends and we're like, okay, it is time to just tear this place up. And we'd request T-R-O-U-B-L-E and get everybody on their feet.
Oh, that's awesome, you know. That's what that song was meant to do, man, is make people, you know, feel like you can go out and party, have a good time. That's great.
Travis, how about you? When you need to kick back and relax, like, what's your guilty pleasure? Are you watching a show right now, or what are you working your way through when you need to relax?
Man, I think we've watched everything that's on Netflix, you know, over the past few months, like everybody else. Of course, we've been shut down for the most part. I'm a little bit luckier than a lot of people. I've had a chance to go out and do, you know, a few shows here and there, but nowhere near as close to as many as I'd like to be doing. We're starting to see things open back up a little bit though, but you know, it's been weird. It's just been strange, you know, because when you're an old road dog like I am, and you like being out there, you live to be out there on stage and performing music for people and get that big ball of energy going back and forth from the stage to the audience and then back again. It's just, man, it's weird. That's the only word I know to describe it. It's strange.
We've asked just about every artist along the way at some point, and somebody like you and what you just described there, when do you remember the last show you did and realizing that, man, something crazy's going on and things are about to change?
Obviously last March, it's just about a year ago. When we did, we were doing a solo run out in solo acoustic show run in on the West Coast. And I mean, you know, we'd come back home. We were getting ready to start doing band dates with Lynyrd Skynyrd. And all of a sudden I came back to Nashville and did rehearsals with the band for, I don't know, a couple of days. And we had our show all ready to go for the Lynyrd Skynyrd dates. And we were supposed to go directly from there. I think we were going to start in Texas or Oklahoma. And all of a sudden we get the word, man, these shows are not happening. And of course, when we started, you know, we didn't know exactly how bad the pandemic was going to be. And we were thinking, well, you know, it'll be, you know, a couple of weeks maybe, or a month at the most. Of course, here we are a year later. And for the most part, you know, we were the first business to get shut down. And it looks like we're going to be the last one to be opened back up. So that's kind of a strange deal. None of us had ever experienced before.
But I find it interesting, though, after that description, that April Fool's Day, no fooling. He really has a gig on April Fool's Day, Thursday. So if you're in Jupiter, Florida, it's for real, okay?
That's right. That is right.
And then he's going to Ormond Beach and Cocoa and then coming to Murfreesboro, Tennessee in April. So that's as close as you're going to be to Nashville, the first date that you'll be close so that folks can come see you that live in this part of the world, right?
Absolutely. Yeah, and you know, the cool thing about having the opportunity to do the few shows that we've done is that people are hungry for it, man. I think they're as hungry to get back into that experience of live music as we are as artists to get back out there and start delivering it. It's just, you know, you think about the experiences. I know the experiences that I've had even before I got into this business. Of going to concerts. And there's something about that experience that nothing else on the face of the planet replaces. Yeah. And so people are hungry for it. I think it's going to be incredible when things get opened back up and people can go out and start playing live music again. I think the fans are going to show up in droves, and that makes me very, very happy.
So you got a taste of it, though, playing live at the Opry over the weekend. Whose idea was the Chris Jansen duet on Are You Sure Hank Done It This Away?
Chris actually texted me earlier in the week and said, man, would you join me for during my set? Would you join me for a kind of a tribute to Waylon? And I said, man, nothing sounds more fun than that. And of course, I'm a big Chris Jansen fan anyway, always have been. And we've worked on the road together a few times in the past. But to get that opportunity on the Opry stage to work with somebody of Chris's talent and also to pay tribute to one of my heroes, Waylon Jennings, that's a win-win.
You know, they asked Waylon, why you do that, Waylon? I said, because Roger Miller did. That's why.
Good enough reason.
Travis Tritt, the new album, Set in Stone, full album comes out May 7th, dropping the new single, Smoke in a Bar Today, which we opened with. Working with Dave Cobb, that's a new relationship for you.
You know, it was exciting because I hired a new manager, guy named Mike Cheese Brown, about 2 years ago. And one of the first things, I've never been very good at multitasking. I've always been one of those people that I get blinders on. And throughout my entire career, I've done that. You know, when it's time to write for a new album, I get laser focused on writing and I don't think about anything else. When it's time to go in the studio and start recording, I get laser focused on that. And then when it's time to tour, I get laser focused on that. And about 12 years ago, I made a conscious decision that all I wanted to do was just focus on the live performance. I've been fortunate enough to have enough hits over the years that I can go out easily and do a 2-hour show or longer. And it's nothing but hits from one end to the other. So I really wanted to just focus on that. And when I hired my new manager, one of the first things that he said was, look, man, you've still got a lot of music left in you and you need to be putting it out. You need to be writing new music. You need to be recording new music. not only to feed your fans that have been with you for a long time, but also to draw in new people as well. So that was the first that I had thought about going back in the studio. And then he mentioned, you know, Dave Cobb is interested in working with you in the studio. And as soon as I met with Dave, he just put me right at ease, because being away from the studio for that long, I know a lot of things have changed as far as how people record music, or how a lot of people record music. But the first thing that Dave told me was, he said, look, here's how I do it. I bring live musicians into the studio and we record everything live, and we try to get as many of your vocals while you're in there playing with the band. We try to get as many of your vocals while we're tracking as possible. Well, that just took me right back to the way that I've always done it. So it was a great, great partnership to work with Dave. And I'm such a fan of how his records sound anyway. So it was a great experience.
Well, Charlie, you know this story. You've heard me tell it through the years. And Megan, you may be hearing it for the first time, but it was 32 years ago in the break room at KKYX Radio, the conference room.
Wow.
That Rick Baumgartner brought this new Warner Brothers artist named Travis Tritt. He was on the radio tour, which I've often said, that's the one where they decide if they don't kill you on tour, you're going to be able, you're going to make it on this label. And where I met him the first time and heard him play and sing. And I remember thinking, man, your rocket ship is ready for liftoff. And it goes with Travis Tritt. Wonderful to have you this morning. Congratulations. Can't wait for the full album, May 7th, set in stone.
Thank you, Travis.
Thank you for having me, guys. I appreciate it so much.
Thanks for listening to our Coffee, Country, and Cody podcast. Our program director at WSM Radio is J. Patrick Tittle. Our digital producer is Haley Hall. Marketing and promotions director is Amanda Cannon. And I'm Charlie Mattos. If you like what you've heard, make sure you subscribe so you never miss an episode. And leave us a review on iTunes. It really does help new people find the show.